Foreign Minister Penny Wong will use a UN summit to lead a global charge for the protection of aid workers in war zones. It follows the death of Sydney woman Zomi Frankcom in Gaza earlier this year.
Seven aid workers were in a convoy when it was hit by an Israeli drone strike in April. They were all killed. One of them was Australian Zomi Frankcom.
This was not a one-off incident. More than 300 aid workers have been killed since the start of the conflict in Gaza. We today collectively want to ensure that their deaths are not in vain.
Zomi was working with the aid group World Central Kitchen. The van was clearly marked. The Israeli Defence Force said it had misidentified the van.
Gaza is the most dangerous place on earth to be an aid worker.
Foreign Minister Penny Wong wants to do something to protect them. She's in New York, securing support from other countries for a global declaration to promote the rights of humanitarian workers. Mal Frankcom is Zomi's younger brother.
I think it's a positive initiative. Anything that can be done to increase the protection for aid workers is a very important thing.
How does a relatively simple declaration actually protect aid workers though?
I think it creates more awareness of the need for them to be protected.
Founder of World Central Kitchen, Jose Andres, was in tears as he thanked Penny Wong. Zomi left Sydney 6 years ago, travelling the world to help where she could.
What do you think she would make of all this?
Knowing my sister, she'd be quite chuffed with it. You know, if she can achieve positive change in the world, she'd be happy with that.
Mark Burrows, Nine News.